So today I'm going to create a video on what foods to eat to break a prolonged fast. Now I already did a video on this, but I want to actually spend some time on some really key points that I didn't cover in the last video and people had questions about it. Now when you're doing intermittent fasting, you don't have to worry about refeeding, but there is something called a refeeding syndrome in which you consume too much food, you feast after a prolonged fast, and you get this shift of electrolytes inside the cells, and you get a depletion of minerals and electrolytes in the plasma, in the blood, and that can create all sorts of problems in the heart. You can feel dizzy, you can have a lot of different problems. So anytime you're doing a prolonged fast, like 48 hours or 72 hours or longer, you want to gradually introduce food, especially if you already have nutritional deficiencies and you might not know it. I've had people eat a very large meal after fasting for even 24 hours and feel really dizzy and even pass out. So the point is that we just want to put some attention on this. So number one, do fasting gradual. Don't go into it like right off the bat and do a 48-hour fast, okay? Slowly go into it, starting with intermittent fasting, and then each month maybe go a little bit longer and longer and longer with your prolonged fasting. There's a lot of benefits of doing this, but again, you have to know how to do it correctly. So when you're fasting, make sure that you're also consuming enough sea salt. Very, very important. Make sure you're consuming electrolytes. Very important. You're not going to have a problem when you do that because there's going to be enough minerals from outside the cell and inside the cell. But if you're not doing enough electrolytes and sea salt, what's going to happen is you're going to have a more difficult time doing it longer. So these two categories of minerals will help you go longer and make it more comfortable to prevent weakness and other symptoms. So here's what you would do. So you're breaking the fast. You would consume maybe a small salad, okay? Maybe you wait like 30 minutes and do 3 ounces of cheese. Now these are just examples of foods. You're not going to consume all of these at once. I'm just giving you examples of what types of food that you want to introduce or start your body to start consuming. And then you're going to wait a little bit and have a little bit more until your body kind of gets used to it. But you could, you know, start off with a small egg. Okay, that could be your first meal, or a little bit of soup, or a little handful of nuts, or a small cup of berries. Okay, and then you wait a little bit, consume a little bit more, wait a little bit, and consume a little bit more. So I just want to make this point because there was some confusion on exactly how you do this and what exactly can you eat. All right, thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next video. Hey, you probably already subscribed, but if you haven't, press this little button down below, and I will keep you updated.